Everyone. How many of you remember this? Today, I'm going to try tearing it apart. So, we can get rid of this silly beeping every time you hit a button. So, got my soldering irons in here, heating up. I got a little tool set. Tools in it. We're gonna try pulling this thing apart and seeing what's inside and see if we can eliminate that beeping. So, the first thing we're gonna do is turn it off. No, I'm gonna leave it on for a little bit. I think the light's cool. So, there's no obvious location to pull it apart. However, devices like this typically, they have these feet on them. They're covered with a little rubberish type piece. My guess is those feet pads cover the screws to take it apart. But nothing holds this lens on. I think I'm gonna pop the lens off first. I think what I can do is this tool set has a little pry bar thing. I think will work pretty good. If I give it back the case. This little real thin little piece of thing. Keep hitting buttons. Maybe I do want to turn it off. And there's that piece off. It doesn't look much different, but it feels very different. Basically just clear plastic. No. Very little sound to it. This, however, it's like an opaque plastic. It's got a just slight texture to it. It's basically used to diffuse that light. Does that pop off too? That might pop off as well. Held on with the screws. So let's see if these little feet. Come off like I think they will. More important tool. Yep. See, pull these little. You can see that. It's a little like sticky sticker thing. And underneath it, I don't know if you can see it. There it just grew. So you pull all of those off.
not screws on from. Just the front ones. Okay. Itty bitty little screws. Ready for me to get rid of that beeper yet? Just a few little LEDs down in there. They shine up and use that as a diffuser. That's saying 60 degrees in here. It's not. It's because my hand is really close to the temperature sensor. Okay. That's a lot easier to read the display now. I wonder if I could put it back together and cut off that bottom half of that. Anyway. Okay. Now there's a bunch of screws that hold that. Bigger screw. It's not huge, but definitely a lot bigger. Okay. Oh, things get interesting. I kind of got to leave the buttons connected. I'll figure out where the beep comes from. The beep don't beep without the buttons. Yeah, it does. Found it. Okay. So what we're going to do is actually disconnect. This is just some ribbons. Oh. Lights off. Just some ribbon connectors. Pretty simple. To take it apart. Yeah. Let's see if you can see this. I'm holding it upside down, but if you look right, I'm trying to do this. Ooh, magnet. Side up, be easier. Let's see, right back there. Now. Let me get the board out and then I'll show you. Here. Disconnected the power. No reason to keep it connected. Nothing's showing up. The temp sensor. Check that out. I didn't notice this before.
temperature and humidity sensor. It looks like a little antenna. It plugs in with a 3.5 millimeter jack. Isn't that pretty funny? All right, anyway. So that's just that. Oh, wow, this just slides right out. I just got to disconnect the speaker. And the board slides right out. That's just the antenna hooked in. So here's the board. And you see this right here, this black round thing. That's the buzzer. So I'm going to take that off. So. Just two little solder points. Basically, I'm just going to those are gone. Let's put back together some wires. Slide this board back in. Back. Let's plug this in. Oh, kind of hard to. There. No beeping. Beeping. Awesome. And so basically, I'm just going to put it back together now. Actually, is a bunch of different LEDs under here. I didn't notice it before. I'm noticing it now. There is the 6 that it's using right now to do the colors. I put that screw in the wrong spot. Yeah. Six that it's using to do the different colors. And what I believe is there is a separate set of them. See, it's using those 6 to do the colors. However, if I switch it to light, it uses the rest of them for the actual like white paint or the orangish colored light for the sunrise effect. Also knows it no longer
shows the temperature humidity. I have it unplugged. And we're back. Celsius. Fahrenheit. And no beeping.
Mention this. I think I'm going to attempt. I'm going to attempt to cut out part of this piece so I can see the display better. I think I can do it. This one's a bit on the wild side, isn't it? Basically, I was going to score in line into it where I want to cut it out. Because I don't think I'm going to cut it out with my knife. It seems like it'd be not as, I don't think it'd work real well. Maybe it will. Maybe I can do it with a knife. It's not super tough plastic, so. Thinking I'm crazy right now. If you don't like the way something is, change it. That beeper was just... Here's that beeper. Just in case. That's all it was. That little tiny thing. Easier to read the time on the clock. I can't see it real well with my glasses off anyway, but this will help. Just need a slightly sharper knife, I think. Thank you.
it's curved. It makes it look heavier.
Any of you read?
So that's got some screws. I gotta go back in it. That beeper was at all useful. I could have left it in there. And wired a switch and put a switch on the outside that's to switch on or off. If I wanted it on, I could have it on. Let's see if these still stick a little bit. I think they will. Yeah, they're still sticking. Cool. Somehow. Not too bad. There. Is that still? Felt funny. There. As good as new. Well, actually better than new. Because it no longer beeps at all. How nice is that? No beeping, and you can read the display nicely and easily. You can tell it's kind of hacked a little bit. Oh, interesting. My temperature was reading 99 there for a minute. There we go. If you look real close, you might be able, you can see that. That wasn't perfectly straight with my lines. I don't think it was too bad. So. Let me know what you thought. I know, not a typical ASMR video, but I hope you enjoyed hacking with me. See you next time.